The third main factorize the given expressions here. First question is ax square plus bx. So here, when you look at this, you will see that one term is common. One factor, see, x is common in both the terms. Ax square plus bx is having x common. So therefore, you take x common, then you will be left with ax plus b. So this further cannot be factorized. So this much only. By taking common factor. So this we can take only common factor x. So you got two factors. One is x, other one is ax plus b. Here, what is common you observe here? In both the places we have number 7. So if you take 3 square, then 7 3 is 21 plus 2 square. So then you cannot, so this c cannot be factorized. B square plus 3 q square cannot be factorized. So only two factors, one is 7, other one is an expression, b square plus 3 q square is the factor. Now here, you can take common from these three terms.
2x.
What is common? 2x is common.
2x.
What will remain when you take 2x common?
X square plus
x square will remain. Here if you take 2x common, y square will remain. And here you are taking 2x common is z square. So the factors are 2x and x square plus y square plus z square. There are three factors. One is 2, other one is x. The third one is x square plus y square plus z square. The question is am square plus bm square plus bn square and plus an square. So you can make these two as one group and these two as another group now. From these two terms, m square is common. You take m square common, you will get a plus b. Here n square if you take common, you will get here b plus a. So b plus a and a plus b both are same. So again we have a plus b and a plus b common. So a plus b you take common. Once you take a plus b common, here m square will remain. Then this plus n square will remain. Look at this. This we are taking common. So these two terms we are taking common. When you take out a plus b outside, so in the first place m square will remain. In the second place plus n square will remain. So don't put box again. While solving this question, this is only to make you understand, that's all. So this we are taking common. So once we take this common, here m square will remain, then n square will remain. So in the first two terms, you can take l common.
And l is common.
So then what will remain? M plus 1.
M plus 1.
So then plus, here nothing is common. So you can take 1. If there is nothing common, then you take 1 common. Then what will remain? M plus 1 only will remain. Okay. So this is one group. From this, we have taken L common. M plus 1 will be there. And these two have no common terms. Therefore, you take 1 as common. So again, you see that M plus 1 in both the places. You take that out. So M plus 1, if you take out, what will remain in this expression? L will remain.
Plus
1 will remain. So if you multiply, then you will get the same expression. M plus 1 into L plus 1, if you multiply, you will get the same expression here. So this is 1. Remember, don't confuse with L and 1. So this is 1. Okay. Already they are taken common here. In this question, y is already taken common. What is remaining here? Y plus z. Here 9 is taken common. Y plus z. And in these two terms, we have only two terms here. This is one term and this is another term. So in this term, we have y plus z common. Here also y plus z. Y plus z and y plus z is common in both the terms. So again, you take out this y plus z. So y plus z if you take out. So here what will remain? Y will remain. And here?
9.
So 9 will remain. So this is the factorization. Y plus z and y plus 9. Where you can take common, you see then accordingly we will take the common terms. So you make this is one group. What is common in these two terms?
So 5y
is common. Once you take 5y common, what will remain in the first term? Y only. Then minus. Divide this one. 5 4s are. So 4 will remain. Y minus 4. And here, now again you take common from here. So I will take common 2 plus 2 I will take common. Otherwise I will rearrange this one because I want y minus 4. I'll write plus 2yz, then minus 8z later. Okay, so I have made some little rearrangement because I want y minus 4. So let us see now, 5y into y minus 4. Here you take common now, 2 is common, z is common. What will remain inside? Y minus 2, 4z. So now again you see y minus 4 and y minus 4 in both the places. You write y minus 4, then 5y plus 2z.
Plus
2z. 5y plus 2z. So this is the solution. Made here, you have to observe this one. Given question.
5y plus 5 will be 1000.
See here, look at this only. See, if you take common here, 2, even you can take common here also. If this one, if you take what happens, you check it down. From here also, you will get some common terms. What is common from these two groups? 2a you take common. 2a if you take common, what will remain?
Sir,
5b plus 2. So here, look at this again, we have 5b plus 2 only. Same thing we are having, therefore let us take one common. So what will remain? 5b plus 2. So now you are having 5b plus 2 here also and here also. Both the places you are having 5b plus 2. Take common that 5b plus 2 outside. So you write outside, then what will remain inside? 2a plus 1. So this is a factorization. So you have to factorize this question, a to the power 4 minus b to the power 4. Now you have to arrange this, you have to arrange right in the form of an identity. What identity you can recall by looking this question? You will recall only a square minus b square, but a square minus b square is equal to a plus b into a minus b, you know that. This is equal to a plus b into a minus b. But it is not in the form of square. Here power is not 2. Here it is 4. But here it is 2. How to make that exponent 2 now? How to make this? I will write this.
A square whole square.
You can write a square whole square minus b square whole square. So now look at this into this to the power 2 and this to the power 2 similar to a square minus b square. Now you write this in the form of a plus b into a minus b. So in place of b, b square. So a plus b means a square plus b square. Then a minus b means a square
minus b square.
Now again, look at this. This you cannot factorize, a square plus b square. But you look at this, it is similar to this one. When it is like this, you can write again a plus b into a minus b. So you got three factors. One is a square plus b square, another one is a plus b and a minus b. This is the factorization. P to the power 4 again. What formula you will recall? You have to arrange in the form of a square minus b square only. So a square means how to write this? P square whole square. Minus this one, how to write? Okay, you can write 9 square. Okay. Now this is in the form of a square minus b square. So you write this in the form of a plus b into a minus b. So in place of a, you have to write b square. In place of b, you write 9. So b square plus 9 into b square minus 9. Again, same way, previous question only. You write this in the form of 3 square now. B square plus 9. This I write b square minus 3 square. Again, this is the form of a square minus b square only. Apply once again here. B square plus 9. If you apply a square minus b square formula, what happens to this one? It will become
b plus 3 into b minus 3.
It becomes b plus 3 into b minus 3. See, we have applied here, this a square minus b square two times. One is here, in this place. A value will be b square, b value will be 9. So b square plus 9, b square minus 9. Again we are applying here, again a square minus b square. In place of a we have b, in place of b we have 3. So therefore b plus 3 and b minus 3. So there are 3 factors to this given expression. Question, we have to arrange this in the form of again a square minus b square only. So you write this in the form of a square minus b square means this will become x square whole square. Minus this will become y plus z whole square all to the power 2. Now you compare this one. In place of a what you can write? X square. In place of b what you can write? Y plus z whole square. Y plus z whole square. Remember that. Carefully compare this one. So you have to write x square in place of a, y plus z whole square in place of b. So a plus b into a minus b. A plus b means x square plus b value, y plus z whole square. Okay, so this is first term. A minus b, x square minus y plus z whole square. See, this is a plus b, a minus b. Because in place of a we have to write x square, in place of b we have to write y plus z whole square. So we can simplify further. So this one you write as it is, x square plus y plus z whole square. Okay, and here again apply the formula. Once again you have to apply a square minus b square formula. Here once you compare, what you will get? In place of a you have to write x, in place of b you have to write y plus z. A plus b, it becomes x plus y plus z. Okay, then a minus b, x minus b means again I write inside bracket. Okay, y plus z, minus of y plus z. A minus b, b value contains two terms. So you write this as it is, x square plus y plus z whole square. This you write as it is, x plus y plus z. And this becomes x minus y minus z. You have multiplied the minus sign inside the bracket. So now, see, this is the factorization of this one, but you can simplify it further. You apply a plus b whole square formula. X square, apply a plus b whole square formula here. A square means y square plus b square means z square plus 2ab, 2yz. So this is one expression. Then another factor is x plus y plus z. Then the third factor is x minus y minus z. So we got three factors. X square plus y square plus z square plus 2yz is one factor. Then x plus y plus z is another factor. X minus y minus z is the third factor. Once again recall, look at this. First you express this in the form of a square minus b square. So x to the power 2 over to the power 2, same as x to the power 4. So a square minus b square, in place of b y plus z whole square. A plus b means x square plus b value, completely you write this y plus z whole square, whatever that is there inside. So this is a and this is totally b. So a plus b, then a minus b value, this one. Whatever they are written inside the red color, that is here a and this is b. A plus b, a minus b, completely are written. Okay, then after this again you can simplify it further. Look at this. This is a square. So look at this. This is a square and this is totally b square. So therefore again a plus b, then a minus b, while writing minus b you have to multiply minus inside, minus b, b two terms. This is a x, b y plus z, a minus b, b value y plus z. So multiply, this becomes minus y minus z. Now this much simplified. After this further you can rewrite in a different form, because this is y plus z whole square. It is in the form of a plus b whole square. That is a square plus b square plus 2ab. So x square you write as this one, this term, this you are written in this way. A square means y square, b square means z square, 2ab means 2yz. So this is this expression. And you write this as it is and this as it is. So three factors. The given question, x to the power 4 minus x minus z whole to the power 4. Now this is in the form of again a square minus b square. You can rewrite in the form of a square minus b square. So I'll write this as x square whole square minus, this will become x minus z whole square all to the power 2. So same as x to the power 4. X minus z whole to the power 4. Now look at this is a square and this is b square. A plus b into a minus b. So a means here x square. So this is a and this is totally b. B value here x minus z whole square. Remember. So a plus b I will write. A plus b means x square plus b means x minus z whole square. So this is first part. A minus b. A means x square minus b means x minus z whole square. Okay. So a plus b, a minus b. So now again, this you can apply a square minus b square once again here. So this is a, this is b. So a square minus b square, you write this as it is. Don't touch this as it is, you write x square, then x minus z whole square. So we have written as it is. You apply the formula a square minus b square. A square minus b square means a plus b. So a means x. X plus x minus z. Then a minus b. Then a minus b.
X minus
bracket once again x minus z. Okay. So you can write this some other bracket. So I'll write the different color. Okay. Now you write this minus inside. Now multiply this minus. This is a plus b. Again a minus b. B here I have two terms. That's why I'm writing inside the bracket. So there is minus sign means you have to write inside the bracket so that every sign changes later. X square plus x minus z whole square. This is first part. And this is x plus x 2x minus z. Then this one x minus x. Then minus into minus plus z. So now plus x and minus x cancels. So this is x square plus x minus z whole square. This is 2x minus z into z only. Only z will remain here. Further you can simplify this. Look at this. This portion. A minus b whole square formula you can apply here. X square. A square. That means x square plus b square z square minus 2ab minus 2xz. This is first part. Then 2x minus z second factor, z third factor. You rewrite x square plus x square. You can write it as 2x square. X square plus x square 2x square plus z square minus 2 plus z square minus 2xz. This is first part. This simplification of this one. Then 2x minus z. This is 2x minus z into z. So these are the three factors. One is this expression completely is a factor. The second expression is also a factor. Third one is z. Suppose there are some questions, look at this, I will give you x square plus 5x plus 6. X square plus 5x plus 6. This is neither in the form of a square plus 2ab plus b square or nor in the form of a square minus 2ab plus b square or not even in the form of a square minus b square. These three identities what you have learned, so all these three are not matching with this one because the last term is not a square number here. So here also not a square number and this is also not matching this one. So you cannot use all these three formulas. But there is one more formula we can use, that is x plus a into x plus b. If you multiply this both you will get x square into a plus b into x plus ab. So this is the fourth identity that we are going to use to solve this or to factorize the expressions of this kind. That means of this kind. It is similar to this portion, right hand side. X square plus y x plus 6 can be written in this form. Okay. So then once you write in this form, then you factorize like x plus 8 to x plus 3. So it is same as x square plus 5x plus 6. So what is the difference here? See, x square and x square is same, and here x is same. So in place of a plus b, we have 5. In place of ab, we have 6. So that means a plus b is equal to 5, ab is equal to 6. But you have to identify what is a and b by looking this. If you add, you should get 5. If you multiply, you should get 6. Okay.
2 and 3.
So then what happens? You will get by inspection method, you can write a value is equal to 2, b value is equal to 3. So therefore, x square plus given question 5x plus 6, it is similar to x square into a plus b into x plus ab. This you can write x plus a into x plus b. Okay, this you can write it as x plus a into x plus b. Now I write this x square. So 2 plus 3 into x, then 2 into 3, so exactly it is matching. So therefore, x means x only plus a value plus 2, x plus b means it is 3. So this is the factorization of this expression. So we follow this method to factorize. Identity x square plus a plus b into x plus ab can be written as x plus a into x plus b.
Show the
bugs. Right. The given question, y square minus 7y plus 12. So you know that formula, x square minus a plus b into x plus ab can be written as x plus a into x plus b. Try to convert this into this formula, y square minus 7y plus 12. So that means a plus b is equal to minus 7. A into b is equal to 12. Compare this one. Since this is plus, a plus b, in place of a plus b, you have minus 7. Okay. In place of ab, you have 12. Now that I have written, a plus b, it is minus 7. Ab is 12. Find out this a and b using these two.
Minus 4 and minus 3.
If you multiply the two numbers, you should get 12. So minus 4 into minus 3 is plus 12. So you got this minus 4 into. The same minus 4 and minus 3 if you add, minus 4 plus minus 3 if you add, you should get to minus 7. So this is similar to this one. Okay. So that means a value is minus 4, b value is minus 3. So and x value here, in place of x, what you have to write? Here it is y. In place of x, what you have to write here? Y. So I will rewrite this one, y square plus, in place of a and b, I will write it as minus 4 minus 3. Minus 4 and minus 3. Into x value, instead of x, you have to write y. Then plus ab, that is minus 4 into minus 3. Minus 4 into minus 3. So now this is equal to x plus a. X means here y.
So y.
Plus a. A value here minus 4.
So
instead of plus you write minus 4. Y minus 4. Then x plus b. X means here y. Plus b means here minus 3.
Minus 3.
So therefore instead of plus 3 you write minus 3. Okay. So x plus a, x plus b becomes y minus 4, y minus 3, because x value is equal to y, a value is equal to minus 4, x value is equal to y, b value is equal to minus 3. Look at this. So therefore, this is the factorization, y minus 4 into y minus 3.